everybody. I'm Michelle from Find Natural Hair and Faith. Welcome to my channel if you're new here, and welcome back if you are not. And I'm going to get right to the subject matter, which is 5 hair mistakes that you could be making that you want to break ASAP. And let me just put the disclaimer out there. I have done each and every single one of these. So I kind of know the effects of these mistakes. If you continue to do them on your hair, it will not be good for you. The first mistake you could be making with your hair is inconsistency with your hair regimen and your hair routines. Now, it's your routines that make up your hair regimen. So I wouldn't use those two words interchangeably. I would say, like, you have a moisture routine, you have a deep conditioning routine, you have a routine for when you, how you trim your hair, and all of that makes up your, the totality of your hair regimen. And so when you're inconsistent with your routines or your regimens, you will not reach the hair goals that you may set for yourself. You may even cause your hair more harm than good. So you definitely want to be consistent with your hair routines and regimen. Second mistake that you could be making with your hair is putting it in tight hairstyles. I'm talking cornrows that are so tight that your edges is all snatched, tight buns, just any tight hairstyle that pulls at your hair. This is especially an issue if you have fine hair, but honestly, any hair type, if you pull your hair tight in tight styles, very often especially, you can cause traction alopecia, which means your hair is basically going to fall out, and it may damage the hair follicle. You can also create split ends by pulling your hair too tight. And when I say split ends, not necessarily on the ends of your hair, depending on how you style it, but also splits along the hair shaft, just from that added stress of pulling your strands entirely too tight. So that's a mistake that if you're making, you definitely want to stop. The third mistake that you could be making with your hair is playing in it. I remember literally just sitting in class in school when I was younger, even at work, like twirling my ends, just literally playing in my hair. When you play in your hair, you accelerate the wear and tear of your strands. It's bad enough we have a natural process for wear and tear, but when you play in your hair or you restyle your hair just for the sake of restyling it, like you're like, oh, I did these braids, but I think I want to do them over again. Just for the sake of redoing your hair, it's too much. It's too much manipulation. So that is a mistake you definitely want to stop. The next mistake that you could be making with your hair is over protective styling. Yes, protective styling is beneficial for maintaining length and giving your hair a break, but you also need to give your hair a rest between protective styles. I follow monthly simplified hair routines where I will do the same hairstyle for a full month. But even for that full month, sometimes I just let my hair breathe for a day or two before I go back into the style I've set myself for the month. So for example, this month, my hairstyle has been all about buns, bunning my hair all month long. And I've pretty much done that, but you see my hair is out now. My hair is out because one, I washed it, and now I'm letting it breathe for a little bit. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to throw in some large dookie twists and just put those twists in a bun. It's good to kind of change it up every now and again, but you definitely don't want to overprotect the style where you just keep your ends hidden away like 100% of the time, because it... Now just let your hair breathe sometimes. Just let your hair breathe. And the final hair mistake that you could be making is closely associated with number 4, and that is not protecting your hair enough. So it's pretty much the opposite. On the one hand, you could be overprotective styling, but then on the other hand, you're not protecting your hair enough. And by protecting, I mean protecting your hair when you sleep at night. Be that scarves or sleeping on a satin pillowcase or putting your hair in a bonnet, whatever it is. Protecting your hair when you travel. Like, I live in New York. Before the pandemic and I had to commute all the time. Right now I'm home all the time, but when I had to commute, even though I wanted to wear my hair out in curls or other hairstyles, I would put my hair up until I got to my destination, because you can accelerate the wear and tear of your strands just by commuting and traveling. Your hair's getting caught on stuff, especially your coat. If it's winter time and you got a wool coat and you're letting your ends rub, you don't want to do that. You just want to make sure you have the proper balance of protective styling your hair when it's necessary and giving it a breather. Well, that is it for the five ways and over the five mistakes that you could be making with your hair. Do any of these resonate with you? If so, leave a comment down below and let me know which one of these that you might be guilty of. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll catch you in my next video. Bye.